What I want people to know is that everything they're doing online is being watched, is being tracked. Every single action you take is carefully monitored and recorded.
Social media companies exist to generate a profit, and frequently they do this at the expense of people's mental health and at the expense of the stability of our society as a whole. I opened this video with a clip from the 2020 Netflix documentary, The Social Dilemma, which details a lot of these problems. I watched the documentary a couple of weeks ago. I was really impressed by it, but I was actually reminded of it from a recent story that I read about a number of teenage girls who've been developing Tourette's-like symptoms through watching TikToks. Now, here's what's wild about all of this. Some of these people are developing facial tics, which are common for Tourette's TikTokers to show off and explain as a way of advocating and finding some normalcy and acceptance within society, which seems to then be transferring out of these people. But not everybody is getting a mild tic, like a facial tic. Many people are picking up complex verbal tics. For example, there's one trend that is carried across TikTok of people being influenced to develop a beans tic. If you don't know what that is, watch this video.
The one tic I was trying not to get is the beans tic, because everyone on TikTok seems to have the beans tic. So I was thinking, oh crap, I might pick that up, because I pick other ticks off really easily. And I have a strong dislike for baked beans, so... I don't really want to be saying beans if I dislike them so much. Beans. Shit. Beans. No, they go away. Bean. Bean. Bean.
And many of these people will go to the doctor and not be diagnosed with Tourette's syndrome. They don't have Tourette's. They have something akin to a mass hysteria, although the researchers still don't know quite what it is, but they have real symptoms. These people cannot stop with these tics. Just as a person with Tourette's can't stop with the tics. And what's clear is that these social media companies are not in it for our health. They are in it to generate a profit. And that is the main message of the Netflix Social Dilemma documentary. And they deliver that message well, and they deliver it artfully. It is a high budget production. And although there are a lot of people interviewed from the left, because these are all people from the technology industry, it does not bash fake news and people on the right more than they deserve to be bashed. I would definitely recommend you check it out. Let's roll a couple more clips from the trailer. I would encourage you to watch it.
If you want to control the population of your country, there has never been a tool as effective as Facebook.
We built these things and we have a responsibility to change it. The intention could be, how do we make the world better?
If technology creates mass chaos, loneliness, more polarization, more election hacking, more inability to focus on the real issues, we're toast.
This is checkmate on humanity.